his mother. Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the flock, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord had appeared to him in a dream and said,
"Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. When Joseph woke up, he remembered the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said,
"Thank you. Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. And you will conceive with my son. And you will be called him Jesus. He will be great. And he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth for about 3 months and then returned home.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken place of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth to Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, to the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
Thank you. And there were shepherds living in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid. I bring you good news. It will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord.
This will be a sign to you. You will find a child wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
On the eighth day, they named him Jesus, the name that the angel had given him before he was conceived.
Bethlehem in Judea, this is what the prophet has written. called the Magi secretly and found out from the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said,
"Go and search carefully for the child. So report back to me. As soon as you find him, go so may I make the
After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
He is grace, born on Christmas Day.
Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to the country by another route.
One who calls you is faithful and will do this. Amen.